Welcome back. My next guest is an American treasure. He's an Academy Award-winning actor. He's got a new TV series called The Crazy Ones, which is Thursday nights at 9 on CBS. Take a look at this. That's genuine love and affection. That you and Betty White—that's the only two that get it.
Thank you for putting me in that category.
Well, I'm just saying. Hey, you look sensational. I like that you're wearing plaid.
Thank you. For you, you. You don't know it.
The thing is, your Scottish accent is so good, I don't understand what you're saying.
That's how good it is. Right,
you're right. You're right away there.
Yes, you can make me.
Take a cat, put a finger in its ass.
Can he say that?
Yes.
What do you mean he can't say? It's Robin.
I can remember.
Williams, man. Do you believe this?
You are a racist.
If I lick a cat, is it right to say lick a cat? But if I say, uh-oh, no.
Okay, good, that's it.
You see the kind of hell I have to deal with here every night.
The line is cat, yes, feline, and then
crikey.
No.
No, yeah. It's very, very difficult.
Can you say cunning linguistics? Talking in tongues.
Talking in tongues.
I can see him going.
You got to be careful with that.
Very much so.
You're the Michael Douglas thing.
Oh, the whole thing.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Made me go back and look at my sexual history, and I thought, phew, thank goodness for that.
Look at a vagina going. Mm-hmm. No.
So, Robin, how's
so that point of view? Going, how are we doing? How are we doing?
How's your CBS sitcom doing?
Sorry. I was just trying to make it look more realistic.
Oh boy.
But it did. The poor guy right now is going, we have nothing so far.
I think it did look realistic, except to look a little 70s because of the hair you got there. Oh. You know what I mean?
Slightly Brazilian.
Yeah, a little bit. So how's the pre-9 o'clock CBS
sitcom? Pre-9 o'clock. None of this would fly. So.
Yeah, you'll be all right. No? Well, what are you doing TV? You haven't done TV since Mork and Mindy, have you?
Yeah, 32 years ago.
Good Lord.
The only thing that was wired back then was me.
Oh, I think there was more than you.
You were
the one on that show.
Yeah, my idea was just I was on everything but skates back then.
Oh, right.
Hi, how are you doing? How's the show? I don't really care. I don't know.
Yeah. It doesn't come across when you look at the old Mork and Mindy's. I see them on cable. You look fine.
We had fun. The first couple of years were really fun. The last few years, it was crazy. I knew the third year things weren't going so well. When I was in Denver Bronco, I was a Denver Bronco cheerleader in Mile High Stadium, dressed as a Denver Bronco cheerleader. And at that point, I went, the end is near.
Yeah. Yeah, that's the joke.
But the last year was great because we went out, you know, Jonathan Winters came on the show. And
oh, I love Jonathan. I'm so sad to hear about it. Oh. He did make it on the show. He did one.
Oh, wonderful.
Yeah.
He was the sweetest man in the world.
Oh, wow. And what a genius of the old comedy business.
Oh, big time.
It was before you corporate monkeys took over comedy and sucked all the... sucked all the... ooh, la, la. Joy out of it.
Well, this word isn't funny to most of America, and we have some reports here that say that many Americans don't find this word funny.
What's that coming ago?
Always work.
Yeah. I think so. And did you know...
And the only guy who can use it in a sentence is Oedipus, you old...
Tutsi frutsi.
At that point, you go, okay, boom.
Have you ever seen any Danish films?
I'm thinking it was Man of Orange, a Danish film.
I think it's probably a Dutch film.
Then now it's like Dutch-Danish, I guess I can't...
Well, the Dutch is they put the finger in the dike to save the country.
Woo!
Yeah.
That'll fly, right?
Yeah, that's a real thing.
That's actually a large body of... Okay.
Yeah. Well, that's the big thing. Have you ever been to Denmark?
No, I've never...
Have you ever assembled any IKEA furniture?
Never. In Denmark, and I've never assembled IKEA furniture in Denmark, which would be the double. That'd be the best.
That's the big one that everyone's after.
Amsterdam is where everything is like, oh, yeah. That's where the hash waiter comes and goes, well, have you tried this? Going, not really.
You been there, Amsterdam?
Never.
It's too late now, man.
If I went there, it'd be over. I'd never leave. I'd be, no. Where are you? I don't know.
Although the thing is about Amsterdam, there's all this. It's very civilized as well. There's lots of very. I mean, they've got the big museum there and some other things.
Totally. What are the other things?
I don't know. I was out my head, but they, you know, there's not like, everyone is out of their mind.
Do they have like a red light district?
Oh yes, they have that. Yeah.
Well, there's basically there's a woman up against the window going, "Look at this. How about here?"
Yeah. No, it's kind of different because what they got is like it's these women who are, you know, state prostitutes. So they're kind of like doing their knitting or reading the paper or something.
That's kind of wondering.
And you go by and they're like, hello. I don't know.
I like the fact she's knitting and also totally nude going, welcome.
Would you like me to move my scarf? Oh.
Well, how are you?
The good news is that now you're on CBS Primetime, they won't censor you at all because they're afraid of you.
They're afraid.
You and David Kelly, it's a David Kelly show, isn't it?
Yes, so oh, he's a sweet man.
He
doesn't laugh a lot. This is David Kelly laughing like, that's it.
That's how you get the intake of breath?
And if he outtakes, then that's huge. It's like, ha, ah, that's boom, that's big time.
He did that. He's done some good shows. He did Ally McBeal, did he?
No, he did Boston Legal.
Boston Legal he did, yeah.
Ally McBeal, yeah. Boston Legal, and that's all I know.
Yeah, that's all I know as well. But they're pretty good shows.
That's why I signed up to do it, because I was meeting with him, and I went, okay, good guy to
see. He's married to Michelle Pfeiffer, I believe.
Yes, he is.
Yes.
She's a nice piece of work, right?
She's lovely. She came here, and she's got lovely skin, Robin. Lovely skin.
That's what I've always thought about. It's lovely to have a girl with lovely skin.
It's nice. So we're doing Scottish hairdressers now. Is that what we're doing?
Two days. You know, I'd never blow and dry on her, but I'd love to do, like, a cream rinse.
I just want to get in there with some volumizer and go, shush, shush, shush.
Moan height, you know, the higher your hair is, the nearer you are to God.
That's right.
That's what I said, right then. Dear God.
True. So, back on TV, I'm kind of concerned, though. You're going to do movies and stuff. You're not going to...
Still have movies. I've done a couple. Friggin' Christmas Miracle is one of them.
Can you say that?
Friggin', yeah, better than...
Crikey.
Christmas Miracle.
Well, that's true.
Right now.
How's your night going, huh? He's a very sweet man, but a racist, I have to say.
But now when you said the country, we don't have to default anymore, which is so great.
Well, that's nice.
I thought they were going to print a new dollar bill instead of In God We Trust, it just says, trust me. And instead of George Washington, it's the little man from Monopoly going...
It's shocking business.
Oh, dude.
This is shocking.
I thought they were going to have to do a telethon for America.
Unbelievable. Unbelievable. I feel very, very bad about this. All of them. The grandstand and political...
Out. Go away. Gone. Yeah, gone. It's a German voice. Go.
Yes, everyone... No.
No, we don't do that. That voice goes away. Yeah.
Okay, get rid of the elected ones.
Yeah. So much for elections.
Yeah. No. No similarities. Just smelling my finger.
Yeah. I have a German character, a German party clown called Schadenfred, who works children's birthday parties. So, children, happy birthday to you. So, look at your country almost about to default. How can you celebrate your birthday right now? Happy birthday, 1 year closer to death. Good luck for you.
Robin Williams. Robin, are you in therapy?
Yes, I am, actually.
Well, I just thought if you're au fait with therapy, then I could do a bit of therapy on you. I'm practicing.
And we can have dueling therapy right now. I could do my therapist, too. We both could be both therapists talking to each other. No, I guess I should be the patient and basically talk to you about this, going, I hear voices, so do I. Shut up, okay.
I like the idea of dueling therapists. I would like to be Austrian, though.
I would be French therapy who goes, whatever happens in life, you deserve it. Get over yourself. It's crazy, you know? With the Sigmund Freud, it's the whole thing about his mother, but also it's sometimes a cigar is a penis. Get over that thing. I don't know. I have a mime cigarette. How French am I? Look at you with your
I have
pipe.
An empty pipe. That's why I'm in therapy.
Both of us are sucking on nothing right now. That's a
nothing
therapy.
Left to lose.
Nothing left to lose.
All right, there with that soundtrack again. One more time with that soundtrack. Okay, that was good.
I dance to Craig to a show with nothing left to lose. Okay, we worked out a lot of things with
yeah,
that therapeutic.
I like the idea of musical therapy. Like, you go into a therapist and then just you have to just riff.
You have to dance like crazy people for a moment and let it out.
You know, you can stop that if you want.
Okay.
Or do you want to stay French for the whole thing?
No.
You're not sure.
That's a therapeutic moment.
Yeah, that's right.
So you do want to stay French. Now I'm a Scottish hairdresser therapist. That's what you've
so,
got lovely
and
skin.
And French Scottish therapist. So we're crazy. It's crazy.
Oh, and we can be two vampires in rehab. Hey, wait. We can call it type AAA. Hi, my name's Vlad. I'm powerless over darkness.
I don't always drink beer, but when I do, I poop my pants and get arrested.
When I have a blackout, it's not a bad thing.
Yes.
Nothing left to lose.
Nothing left to lose.
Well, that's it. We're done.
Serious?
Yeah, that's it.
What? Aww.
Well, I don't make the rules, man. I was just obeying orders. They are saying it's done, I have to say.
So the show is like this. We had a little fun for a brief moment. The moment of our fun was very good. We tried many different things, and I feel good about this moment. For me, it was good. And, you know, it's...
I like the Scottish hairdresser.
I think that's the way to go that way. Don't be afraid.
I'm not afraid.
And your Chinese gangster who sounds Italian.
Where's my money? Where's my money?
Going back to Beijing. I need my money now.
Where's my money?
Don't make me go Shanghai on you.
Yeah.
If I go Shanghai, it's bad. Or Chris Walken is a Chinese Scottish gangster.
No, weird.
Christopher Walken, Chinese Scottish gangster. Oh, yours, man. That's ahead of me.
This accent's strange. I don't know how. This is the strangest accent I've ever done. But I think it's in the category of what?
Strudel.
Craig Ferguson, ladies and gentlemen.